My husband came on Friday with a brand new motor car. He told me I could drive it. I said, Brian, you're a star. We drove down to the boozer for a vodka and a fag. Then, of course, we had to celebrate the purchase with a shag. We go doggy, we go doggy. We're a treat for any passers-by out jogging. We do it because we found that when people crowd around, it is somehow more profound when you're dogging. I just say hang on in there, and I think the meaning will shine through. Bill, how are you doing? Anyhow, if you are still a little bit in the dark at the end, just ask a young person or Google. Just don't take your computer for repair immediately afterwards. Well, we drove down to the far end of the car park back of Asda. A threesome was hot at it in a sporty little Mazda. It made it more exciting as they pressed against the glass. And when Brian got his torch out, you could see right up her ass. They were dogging. They were dogging. Believe me, they were more than merely snogging. But though her cheeks were parted, she spoilt it when she parted. And we wanted to get started on our dogging. We rushed back to our car because we were randy as two goats. But being late November, we had on our duffel coats. We should have stripped off first before getting back inside. Because disrobing in a smart car isn't easy. Have you tried? We were dogging. We were dogging. In the struggle, poor old Brian tore his frogging. Our apparel was misguided because when our heads collided, Brian's manhood then subsided with us dogging. This was a setback, but I wasn't beaten yet. Cause I'm really very handy with my man's beef bayonet. I quickly had his back put up, responding to my touch. And the next thing I was upside down and staring at the clutch. We were dogging, we were dogging. The heat was on to stop the windows fogging. Thank God for plastic sheeting, well one must protect the seating. Cause the fabric takes a beating when you're dogging.
Anyone join in with your dogging?